All right. Well, welcome everybody. Dr. Jabber and myself, we are here today to visit with you about your Nursing 310 course, to offer any answers to any questions we may get asked, and then to just kind of go over the requirements, talk a little bit about the assignments. So I'm Dr. Sheila Mady, and I am physically sitting in Montana. I've been with Eaglegate for 2 years now, and have been teaching nutrition plus some of your later on classes towards graduation. I really, really enjoy this program. I really enjoy the students. I am here. I'm open. I'm flexible for students to ask questions. My whole thing is, please don't feel like you cannot email me or text me and ask me a question. I'd rather have you do that versus sitting, being frustrated about an assignment or about maybe some of the feedback I gave you. And so please feel free to do that. And then I will let Dr. Jabber introduce herself.
Hi, students. Hi, welcome. My name is Rana Jabber, Dr. Rana Jabber. I live in California with my family, state of San Antonio, and I'm working now with Eaglegate. I was working with Cal State, University of Dominguez Hills, and several places. I have a good experience with online teaching, and I enjoy the online teaching, enjoy communicating and talking to you. And if you need any help, like Dr. Sheila was saying, if you need any help, if you need anything, don't hesitate to contact us, like text, email, call. We are here for you, and I want you to call us or like text us always and ask questions if you need anything before grading, because I hate to see somebody fail, or I hate to see somebody like has the problems without asking or without contacting any of us. Okay, thank you so much, and waiting for your text and your emails and anything you want. Okay, thank you. Now, back to Dr. Sheila.
Hi, and sorry about that. My dogs were barking. I have three chihuahuas, and every movement outside, they have to be protective. So I apologize for that. So let's talk a little bit about some of the resources that we're offering. And so I'm sharing my screen. So Dr. Jabber, at any time you cannot see my screen, will you please just let me know?
Okay, sure.
So on the left-hand side, you'll see where it says home. And if you click on home, this will take you to your most current announcements and then also the course syllabus. Now, the course syllabus, this is where you can find Dr. Jabber and my's contact information. So, and then our office hours. So I would ask you to please reach out to Dr. Jabber and myself if you have any questions. Our email address is there, and then our cell phone numbers are there. Now, course description, I know that you've probably already read your syllabi, so I'm not going to go over a lot of the syllabi with you. Towards the end, you will see some of the policies. One of the biggest ones would be plagiarism, that when we look at your papers or any of your assignments or any of your discussions, we try to stay within that 80-20 rule, which means that we would like 80% of what is written in your own words. And then if you go, you know, if you have a lot of quotes within your discussions or within your assignments, we add it up. And if it's over 20%, then we take points off for that. So, you know, go ahead and use quotes. Make sure that you cite them appropriately by adding a page number or a paragraph number from where that direct quote came from. But make sure that you're limiting that to 20% and under. Any questions with that? Anybody? Dr. Jabber, nothing. Okay. Professionalism, I think you guys are all aware of that. Late work. Now, late work, your assignments, you can turn in late up to Wednesday. The first day that you're late, you'll get 10% deduction. The second day late, you'll get 20%. The third day late, you'll get 30%. We cannot accept assignments after Wednesday at 11:59 p.m. So just remember that. Discussions and quizzes are not allowed to be turned in after the due date. Okay. Attendance and participation, since we are just getting into week two, we take attendance twice a week. We take attendance Monday morning and Thursday morning. So just be aware that you're being asked to be active in the class 2 days a week. Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, we're asking you to be active. And then we're asking you to be active again on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or Sunday, which I think is very doable within your busy schedules of working and then other classes on top of that. So if you notice that maybe we're sending emails out talking with you about being absent, it's just so we can keep track and just to give you a quick reminder of, hey, make sure that you're active this week in the class. Any questions, please feel free to reach out to Dr. Jabber and myself. Civility, incivility. As we go further down, you'll have a breakdown of where the points are at. And so I'm not going to go over those. You can look at them. Look through them and make sure you ask any questions you may have. So I think the course outline is really good for you to print out, just so you have an idea of what's expected of you each week. Now, I know these first couple weeks aren't too bad. Now, after week five, you've got an assignment due in week five. You've got an assignment due in week six. You've got an assignment due in week seven. So, you know, the first part of the class is just getting your feet wet, kind of figuring out how we grade, kind of, you know, what is expected of you. And then you really need to get your feet running in weeks five, six, and seven. Anything else with the syllabus I'm forgetting, Dr. Jabber?
No.
Okay.
It's like, you cover everything.
Okay. Next, you're welcome. The next tab would be announcements. Now, this is where faculty will, anything important, we will add to the announcement section. And we would ask that you read this daily. We're not always going to email you these. We put them in the announcement section, hoping that you will read them, just like our welcome message. And then some of the other announcements you'll see are how to contact us, welcoming you to the class, your ebook code, and then scholarly list, a list of credible websites. So we would ask that you look at your announcements and read them daily. Other than that, let's see. Chat, you know, Dr. Jabber and I don't utilize chat. Myself, personally, I've never utilized it, but I'm not saying I can't do it. But I rather have you call me on the phone and visit that way. Just because I think it's more personalized that way. What about you, Dr. Jabber?
If they need to use it, that's fine. I think that's fine. For me, that's fine. If they prefer to use the code chat, that's okay. But as you said, I prefer like a phone call or like a text or something.
Sure.
But it's available. So if they prefer to use it, that's okay with me. I can do it.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Okay. Perfect.
Yeah, but I think it's more like a more comfortable for them too, also convenient for them too, not
sure
just for us. They can call us anytime.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Perfect. Next would be conferences. Now, this is where, if Dr. Jabber and I decide to have individual conferences within each of our sections. Now, Dr. Jabber, you'll notice, has she teaches two sections of nutrition, and I teach two sections of nutrition. And so you may notice throughout that if Dr. Jabber decides to do an individual conference for her individual class, then she will let you know. She'll give you an announcement and then go ahead and make this active. And so what we call these conferences are the big blue button conferences. So keep an eye out for those if we decide to do those. You will find that within your announcement or maybe an email. discussions. So this is a big part of your class is discussions. And so you'll see my screen here with discussions. Make sure the questions to the instructor, this is a great venue for you to ask questions about an assignment. If it's more personalized, we would ask that you email us or call us, just so everything's not out on the Canvas for your class. But if it's an overall generalized discussion about an assignment or about something pertaining to the class, please use this venue. Eagle Gate Cafe is where we welcome you to the class. So if you have yet to introduce yourself, please go ahead and introduce yourself. You guys as students may know each other, but as faculty, we may not know you. And so that we ask that you go ahead and utilize Eagle Gate Cafe and introduce yourself. Now, each week you'll have questions that are pinned. Requirements for discussion questions, you're to answer the initial discussion question by Wednesday at 11:59 p.m. And then you're to come in either on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday and visit with or respond to at least two of your peers. Make sure that you do that within two separate days. If you're doing all of your work on one main day, you will get points taken off for not being active twice a week. So if you have any questions about what is required of you regarding attendance, please reach out to Dr. Jabber or myself. So anything else with discussions, Dr. Jabber?
Yeah, about discussion, I want them all to be present and to post their discussions. It's very important. We don't want them at the end of that semester just to come and they need like a 1 point to pass the class. Or if you got like a quiz 40% or your grade is you got 40 in your quiz and you are absent, you will get 7 out of 25 or something in your discussion. This is not good. So I need you to just go ahead and do your discussion and look at the question. Look at the discussion point, what the instructor is asking. The question is asking about something specific. Answer the question. Don't go around in circles. Just go ahead and this is what I noticed in your while grading your discussion. Just go ahead and answer the question. That's it. Thank you.
Perfect. And I would just reiterate as well what Dr. Jabber said. You know, get in and answer your initial question by Wednesday. Points at this stage of the game are so very important. Every point counts. And so please do your best. Please be active. Please participate. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us. And then modules is a great tab because what this does is it gives you a breakdown of each week. And so if you need a Canvas, if you need a little more orientation to Canvas, this is a link that'll help you do that. Helpful Canvas student videos, your course tools. This is where you can find your APA template, an APA sample, and a PowerPoint. And so you have a lot of resources at your fingertips. You just need to find them and utilize them. So if I click in this APA template here, and I know APA is just so far out there right now, which is very normal at your level. But the reason we ask you to write in APA is because you are professionals. You're learning to be professionals. And what you write and how you... Sorry. Hello? About that. My dogs were barking. Sorry about that.
Oh, that's fine.
So we're very, very professional people and we're asking you to do this. We're not just making you do it just because it's something frustrating or something hard. It means your being, it's your professional being. And so if you're like, well, gosh, I don't know how to do the margins. I'm not sure about the running head. You know what? This template right here is amazing. And so go ahead and download it. and go ahead and utilize it. And so the running head is already here for you. The title page is already here. You just have to change the name. You know, change the name of the title, put in your name. It's for Eagle Gate College, and then whatever course you're in. But the pages are done for you. The margins are done for you. The level headings are done for you. You just have to go in and add your own information. And so feel free to utilize this resource. Download it. Make it your own. Individualize it. There's no reason that you should not be utilizing this for proper APA. There's also some videos. There's a full-length video, and then there is a condensed video on APA if you just have to, you know, refresh yourself. So please feel free to download these, utilize them. There's really no reason that your discussions and your assignments should not be in APA formatting. So your in-text citations, you can learn how to do these appropriately. I know all of you have had your 125 course. And I know, again, that was a lot of information thrown at you at one time. But watch these videos. It'll give you a refresher course on how to cite appropriately. And you'll know that during week one discussion grading, Dr. Jabber and myself, we are very, very specific on grading criteria. And if you are missing certain criteria, you know, we are consistent in our grading. We are following policy within our grading. And I know that you're very new, but just know that the consistency within grading will be throughout your nursing school. And so maybe you're going to say, well, I've never been graded like this before, and that's okay. But from now on, you're going to be graded on your APA formatting. You're going to be graded on professionalism. You're going to be graded on, you know, what you've written. And so please feel free to reach out if you have any questions. But I believe all of you should have received your feedback, or hopefully have looked at your feedback from your week one discussions. We hope that you integrate that feedback and improve your discussions for this week, and then every week continued. So any questions or any extra discussion, Dr. Jabber?
No, I'm okay with that. Like, no. Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah. Perfect.
And then the if we click on the Pages tab, oh, let me go back to modules. Sorry. So every week you'll see where your modules, you'll have your checklist, your objectives, then you'll have your lecture and your readings, then you'll have your discussions, and then your quiz or whatever's due. So week two is pretty much the same. So week five, you'll notice it looks a little different because you have an assignment here. And we'll go over those major assignments here in just a little bit. Week six, week seven.
About the readings. Mm-hmm. The readings, just go to your text and read, and you have a lot of resources. Like, for example, if you don't want to read the chapter, just go ahead and read, like, take a look at the PowerPoint. There's a mm-hmm. lot of PowerPoints. Good, very good PowerPoints.
Yeah.
It's like a summary for all the textbook. So just use your resources.
Yeah.
This is very important.
Yeah. Yeah. And again, I'll just reiterate, you know, one of the major resources are the lectures that we put together for you. There are links within the lecture that will guide you, that will give you information so you can appropriately answer each weekly discussion questions. And so, you know, I would just tell you, please read your lecture. Utilize the resources within your lecture. You know, at the end of each lecture here, I'll show you, you have resources. So one of them is your textbook. Please use your textbook. It's very well done, and we really utilize the textbook when we write our discussion questions. And then some of the other resources, I would just ask you, utilize them, you know, because excuse me, but I think this week one, I took off for not having scholarly articles, but your textbook is scholarly, so there's really no reason you should not get points for scholarly because your textbook is one of them. Most of you, or if not all of you, should have your textbook by now. You should have your e-code. You should be able to download it. Please utilize your textbook. There's really no reason not to answer your discussion questions every week.
Exactly.
Yep.
Instead of just getting any information from any resource that is not accepted, not scholarly, just use the references that we provided to you. Look, there's like at least the textbook.
Yep. It's it's right at your fingertips. You all have it. The textbook is cited in appropriate APA formatting for you. So just copy and paste into your discussion, and then make sure that you have your in-text citation reflective of APA formatting. So don't make it too hard on yourself. Everything is here at your fingertips. We have a lot of resources within EagleGate, and we hope that you utilize those. Okay. So I think we're done with modules. If we click on pages, this is another area that will guide you to the academic catalog and then also to your student handbook. So we follow that student handbook. It has a lot of our policies in it. And we pride ourselves as faculty with EagleGate to follow policy and follow the handbook. And so if you have a question, please look in your handbook. Please reach out to Dr. Jabber and myself, and we can guide you there. Some of the other resources would be technical support, if you're having technical support, any help within Canvas, your library resources. So I'm going to click on library resources, and here is your approved list of scholarly resources. And so if you were... if you had points taken away in week one because you did not have a scholarly resource, this is where we utilize. This is where we would refer you to. And so you're, you know, you're utilizing .gov.org, your textbook, your assigned readings by faculty. Now, if you have a .com resource, that's usually 99.9% not scholarly. One of the ones that I noticed this last week that students were using was WebMD. That is not scholarly. So make sure if you have any questions to reach out to us or utilize this resource and say, gosh, I'm not sure if this is scholarly. And again, I would tell you, use your textbook. You know 100% that that is scholarly. Okay. Here, another link is how to go into the LIRN, the library. And I would ask of those of you who might be uncomfortable utilizing it, which is very normal, reach out to Dr. Jabber and myself, and we will help you understand how to utilize the LIRN. There's just a couple clicks, and then you can find an article. ProQuest in itself will cite the article in APA format for you, so there's really no reason not to utilize it. So there again, I'm not going to utilize this venue to go over how to access the LIRN. Everything is here for you. But if you want maybe a one-on-one, let me know, and I do not mind doing that with you. It'll take probably 10 minutes is all. So please reach out. Don't wait until the end when you have to find a scholarly article and now you're frustrated, you don't know how to use it, you're uncomfortable. Let's work those bugs out together, okay, early on. APA writing help, how to access Office 365, our EagleGate College Group Emergency Preparedness Plan, and then student services resources. And this is all found within your pages tab. So a lot of great information here. Okay. Any questions or concerns or anything else you would like to add, Dr. Jabber?
No, thank you.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So those are the main tabs on the left that I want you to be aware of. So let's go ahead and dive into our assignments because we're already 33 minutes past the hour. So if we were to go to our modules tab, our first assignment is due in week 5. So let's go ahead and click on it. And this is a holistic nutritional assessment. And you'll see 3 links. And so let's dive into the first link, which is your table. So once you click on that and you bring up your table, this is what you will turn in. This is not a paper. This is a fill in the table. So once you download and you start typing in these blanks, the blanks will move as you start typing. So utilize this, download it. So you're going to be talking, let me minimize that. And let's go to the actual directions. All right. So this is worth 200 points or 20% of your grade. This is a lot. So even though it's not due until week 5, let's start working on it now. All right. We're asking you to choose someone and do a thorough nutritional assessment on them. You can utilize a patient that you've had in clinical recently. It cannot be yourself, but it can be a family member, a friend, a coworker. And then utilize the table to document each of those areas, which we're going to go over here shortly. Perform a nutritional history. Perform a physical assessment related to nutritional assessment. If available, if somebody just had their yearly lab work, which a lot of us do, go ahead and bring that information forward and put it, document it in that table. And then we're asking you to interpret the assessment data and then prepare 2 nutritional outcomes or goals. Now, those outcomes or goals need to be SMART, and that's what we mean by being measurable, attainable, specific, and patient-centered. And then include at least 1 intervention for each of your outcomes or goals. Now, knowing that, you know, in nursing, we're not ever going to do just 1 intervention and then the patient's better. We utilize quite a few of interventions, but we're just asking you to create 1 intervention, okay? We need at least 2 scholarly resources and then utilizing a 6th edition APA format, okay? Now, here's also the grading rubric on, well, what's expected of me? How will I be graded? Here is what's expected of you, all right? Here is the points that we are going to take off, and we will follow the grading rubric. We will be consistent in following that grading rubric. So go ahead and read through that. I'm not going to go through everything, but let's go ahead and bring up that. Let me go ahead and bring up that table again. Where is it? Nope. Sorry. Nope. Sorry. Well, let me just pull it up here again. All right. So the first blank is age and growth and development stage. So how old is your patient? And then according to Erickson's, what stage of growth and development is your patient in? Now, consistently students forget this. Make sure that you utilize your textbook. Make sure you utilize some of the Erickson's stages of growth and development to let us know what stage they're in. So there should be no reason that this should be left blank. And then the other part of the table is your interpretation. So this is very, very important. I cannot stress this enough. The interpretation means what are you thinking? This is where Dr. Jabber and I will be able to understand if you're critically thinking. So let's talk, an example would be clinical signs, physical signs and symptoms of malnutrition observed in the patient. Let's say your patient is underweight and does not have a good diet history or has a nutritional deficit. You know, maybe the BMI is lower than normal. So what does this mean to you? Instead of just saying, well, the BMI is, you know, not normal. But what does that mean to you? Let Dr. Jaber and I know what is on your mind. You know, this is where you are going to utilize your resources. This is where you will find your resources being cited. This is the area that we would look for those resources being cited, because that information doesn't just come from the top of your head. It's because you've read something in your textbook, or you've read something within a scholarly article that tells you they are at nutritional risk. And so we want to see this interpretation data. The biggest thing is, do never leave one of these areas blank, because you will be given 0 points for that. So I'm hoping this makes sense. Now, I do have some examples of some well-done holistic nutritional assessments that have been done. So please feel free to reach out to Dr. Jaber and myself after you have watched this video. And if you would like to have those examples sent to you, please let us know and we will definitely send you those, just so you can get an idea of what's expected of you. So each area has to be filled in. 24-hour diet recall, any allergies. Now, let's say they don't have any allergies and you want to type in no known allergies here. But what does that mean to you? The interpretive section over here, you cannot leave blank. What we're trying to find out is, okay, currently they don't have any allergies, but let's just say they developed an allergy. And you could pull an allergy from, you know, let's say they currently don't have any, but if they develop a gluten allergy, this is what I would expect to see. And this is what maybe some education would look like. And so do not leave anything blank if it's not applicable. So sometimes the alcohol consumption, students will say, well, the patient does not consume alcohol. That's awesome. But what does it mean if they did over here in the interpretive section? Although my patient or my person does not consume alcohol, if they did, what's the outcome regarding nutrition if they consume alcohol? What are some things that some deficits that you might notice, or what would be education? What would your education look like if they were consuming a lot of alcohol? So here again, I just keep stating, do not leave any portion of this blank. If it's not applicable, I do not want you to say not applicable, because the interpretation section is where Dr. Jaber and I will understand if you're critically thinking, that we want you to be able to pull theory from your lectures and from your textbook into this assessment, okay? And then economics related to food intake. So are they homeless? They don't have to worry about anything related to food. They can eat whatever they want. That's fine. But just what does that mean to you? Interpretive section. So, you know, I'm hoping I'm making sense when I'm asking you to give us the what ifs in the interpretive section. You know, if you are assessing a patient that has absolutely everything's perfect about them, they're not obese. Their BMI is fine. They're not on any meds that would hinder their nutrition. If everything looks good, you still have to let us know what you're thinking, the what ifs. What if their BMI was high? What if they had allergies? What if they consumed alcohol? What if they were homeless? So this is where we really, really want you to critically think. And then down here would be, according to everything that you've written now, what would be a nutritional outcome or goal? And then what would be one intervention to that? And then a second nutritional outcome or goal? And then a second intervention? And then the last part would be your references. These have to be in APA format. And then Dr. Jaber and I would expect to see in this interpretive section here, this is where you're going to cite your resources. So over in the assessment findings is just that. This is what I found. There's no reason to cite research here. But in the interpretive section, research is going to guide you on your critical thinking. And so we would hope that we would utilize, you know, Eric Erickson's Stages of Growth and Development, your DUDEC textbook. This is where we would expect to see that. Okay. So this is just a table you're going to fill out. You're going to upload it. It's not a paper. APA formatting will be evident within your interpretive section of your citations and then your references down here. Okay.
Mm-hmm. So think out of the box and use your analysis for the data. First, go to the rubrics. If I were you, I will read the rubrics and because your grading criteria will be or evaluation will be from there, from the rubrics. So start with the rubrics, reading your rubrics before you start. Just to know the information, that would be
Like this, the grading rubric down here. So you've got, let's go to the alcohol question because this is missed a lot. Alcohol consumption. So if the data says no known or does not consume alcohol, awesome. But the interpretive section, if you just leave blank, you're going to get 0 points because you didn't discuss it. Mm-hmm. And so really put something in there so Dr. Jabber and I can grade you accordingly to your critical thinking. But if the patient consumed alcohol, this would be some signs and symptoms of malnutrition according to how much alcohol they drank, something like that. Okay. The other one would be your allergies right here. If you don't add that, then that's going to be 0 points, and right off you're taking 20 points off of your 200. So really, I just want to stress, do not leave anything blank. If there's nothing written in there, or if you write not applicable, that's the same as being blank, and you'll get 0 points for each of those sections. So there's really no reason for you to not turn in a well-done table. Because you will utilize this recording and you will reach out with any questions you may have to Dr. Jabber and myself so you can turn in a well-done product, okay? All right. So the next major assignment will be in week six. So week six, you have an ATI practice assessment, and this is a practice assessment regarding nutrition, and it's graded according to if you do it. So you get 20 points. So we expect you to do it. Now, if you get a failing grade, it's okay because we are asking, it's just practice. And so we're hoping that this practice will help guide you to at the end of your semester or at the end of your student nurse career when you're taking your NCLEX. We're hoping that this information will help you. And so make sure that you, give yourself time to do it. Don't do it on a Sunday night at 10 o'clock at night. You know, you have you can do it now if you want. I just tell students, don't wait until the last minute, because the biggest part of this is your remediation. And if we were to click in here, the remediation will take you some time. So here are the instructions. Please follow the instructions. And then remediation may be done by using the templates or choosing 3 critical points. So even if you get 100%, which students have gotten 100%. I can honestly say it's rare, but they do get 100%. And then they're like, well, I don't have to do any remediation. Well, you are expected to do remediation. So we want you to look at 3 critical points. What were 3 points that you want to dive into deeper? And so remediation, maybe on any topics you missed, or if you didn't miss any topics you want to dive into. Okay. You will have 60 minutes. And we need to see that 60 minutes. And so you just can't go in and take 5 minutes. We need to see that you've been remediating for a full 60 minutes. Your remediation areas must be handwritten. And so you're going to handwrite those and then take a picture and upload those. Okay? Because when students handwrite notes, they learn better than just copying and pasting. And so that's why they have to be handwritten. We want to know that you did spend some time doing this. If you look through here and you have questions, please reach out to Dr. Jabber and myself. And so in order to earn 20 points, you have to complete both the exam and the remediation. Now, this cannot be done late. This has got to be done by the end of week 6, that Sunday at 11:59 p.m. But you can do it at any time from today forward. Okay. Modules again. We'll go into week 7. Now, here are your templates. If you want to utilize a template, let's just look at the 3 critical points. It's a PDF, and let me show that to you. So this is what it would look like, okay? Choose a topic. Go ahead and read through here, and if you have any questions, but it's just a handwritten of 3 critical points, okay? So there's that one. Go back to modules. I hope I'm not making anybody nauseous, but that tends to happen. And then these are the templates. And so let's say you wanted to talk more about medications. You would click on here and you would download and you would print it off and you would handwrite your name, a medication that you might have missed, or if you did well on them, just a medication that you would like to know more about, the class, and then fill in each of these areas and then take a picture and upload it. Okay, so the templates are here for you to find within your modules tab within week or module 6. Okay, and then your end of course survey. So as soon as that becomes available towards the end of the semester, Dr. Jabber and I will let you know, and then you can go in and take that survey. And then in week 7, we have a nutritional health plan PowerPoint presentation. So I will go ahead and pull that up to show you. So this is worth 165 points, or 16.5% of your overall grade. You are to choose one area of interest from the following topics. Could be cancer. Oh, let me see. Do we have a student visiting us? Nope. I just heard a tone, so I wanted to make sure.
Yeah, me too.
Okay.
So,
So you're to choose cancer. Now, it can be any type of cancer, okay? And then cardiovascular disorder. Celiac disease, diabetes, HIV, AIDS, or kidney disorder. These are what we would like you to choose from. And then choose one of the areas of interest, identify the disease or disorder, and summarize nutritional needs and recommendations. Discuss at least 3 elements of a dietary assessment. Plan 4 nutritional interventions to include A, B, C, and D. And then describe at least 3 expected patient outcomes as a result. You are to include a title reference, or a title slide and a reference slide. We would hope that you would have at least 5 to 7 slides in length. This does not include your title slide or your reference slide. So those are above and beyond 5 to 7. And then we would ask that you have speaker notes. So this is where if you were to present this, you put minimal wording on your PowerPoint slide, but then underneath in speaker notes is where you would go into detail about what you're talking about. because when you are presenting a PowerPoint, you don't just stand up there and read it because everybody can read it. You put interesting points and then you dive into those interesting points within your speaker notes. And also within the speaker notes is where you would do your citations, your in-text citations. And so if you do not have speaker notes, Dr. Jabber and myself, we will not be allowed to, or we're not given the opportunity to grade you on your APA because you don't have any speaker notes. But then we also, is it plagiarized because there's no in-text citations? There's nothing telling us where you got this information. So make sure that you add speaker notes. And down here in this last big bullet is where we talk about, well, how do I add speaker notes? It's explained to you right here. Okay. So again, I would ask that you not wait until the end of week 7 on Sunday to start this. Start it now. If you do a little bit each day, by the time it's due, you will have a good product. Okay. And I would ask again, if you would like an example of some well done presentations, please let Dr. Jabber and myself know, and we will give you some examples. Okay. But we're only doing that for the students who have listened to the course overview and have reached out to us asking us for those. So if we do not have students asking for those, we will assume that students are not listening to the recording, which ultimately will help with your success. Okay. All right, there's that. And then the grading rubric is attached. So if you forget one area, so if you do not identify the disorder or the disease or disorder or summarize the nutritional needs and recommendations, you'll get 0 points out of 30. So make sure that you are aware of what the grading rubric shows and what's expected of you. If you read through it and you have questions, reach out to Dr. Jabber or myself and we will help guide you. Okay. So I think we are, you know, we have two major assignments. We have an ATI assessment. We have quizzes every week, which are open book, and you have two attempts at those. We've talked about discussion requirements, about participation requirements. Anything else, Dr. Jabber, that you can think of that we didn't talk about?
Pretty much everything. We cover everything for them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. So what you can expect from Dr. Jabber and myself is once we're done, the recording I will upload and we will put a link within an announcement and we would ask that you watch it and take notes and ask questions, write down questions, and then go ahead and find us and ask us those questions. Because Dr. Jabber and I are here for your success. EagleGate offers a lot of resources that you guys have at your fingertips. We offer a full-blown library. So there's no reason not to be successful. And we know that life happens. So please keep up with us and let us know, you know, if you need anything from us. Towards the end of the 8 weeks, we need you to know that there's no extra credit that we hand out and that we will always follow policy and we will be consistent in our grading. But if you look at your feedback and you are questioning that, the best thing to do would be to reach out to your instructor and talk to them about that. Because we are human, we do make mistakes, and just know that we are here for your success, and anything that you need from us, we are here for you. So, okay.
Yeah, okay. Just be present.
Yep.
Present in your...
Yep. All right.
This is what you want. Be there for them.
Right.
Be there for you. If you are there.
If you're there, we're there for you.
Of course.
All right. Okay.